Hey guys, welcome back to FedEx Gaming's Redstone Tutorials. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you guys how to build my two-wide hidden staircase. So if we flip this lever right here, our two-wide staircase opens up. We can go down inside of it, we can go up, you know, all that good stuff. And I also have a button right here so we can close it and open it up with a button as well. So we go down it, here's the button on the inside, click it. Now, you can see the redstone right here when you close it. So I do have something at the end. I will show you how to hide this if you really want to. And also the button is also another little add-on at the end as well. It will not have anything to do with the actual build itself. So this thing's actually pretty easy to build, guys. It's not too difficult. So let's just start building this thing right away. All right, guys, so this build is obviously not going to be this small, but if you want to just build one side of it, you can, because the thing is just mirrored. It's just mirrored. So if you want to build it one wide instead of two wide and save on some resources for survival, then go right ahead. But if you're not, then for this build, we're going to need a 4x4 spacing. We're also going to have to dig down 5. And then this one little area right here, we're going to have to dig down 6. Now for this build, we're going to need some blocks to put our redstone down on, 14 sticky pistons, 2 powered rails, 10 redstone dust, 2 slabs, 18 redstone repeaters, some blocks of choice, 2 redstone torches, and a lever. And then this stuff right here is just for the add-ons at the end in case you don't want to see the redstone, and for the button as well. Now, if you're only going to build one side of this, then just half all this. You don't need this much stuff. Just half it all if you're going to build it only one wide. So once you got your 4x4 and you've dug down your 5, you're going to come to the bottom left-hand side, and we're going to count over 4 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to count up 3 blocks. 1, 2, 3. And right here, we're going to put 2 sticky pistons on top of each other. This will create our double piston extender. And then we're going to put a block of choice right above it. To the left side of our double piston extender, we're going to put another sticky piston facing upwards next to our block of choice, with another block of choice on top of that. And then on the bottom side of our double piston extender, we're going to put another block of choice. This will create the little kind of staircase we go down to get to our little secret area. And then from this block of choice, we're going to come out 2 more. 1, 2. And then we're going to go right here and put 2 sticky pistons facing towards us, and then 1 sticky piston facing upwards with a block of choice on top of it. And then we're going to delete these 2 blocks underneath it because we need this spacing. And that's all our pistons for our whole opening and closing circuit. So let's start doing some redstone. So what we're going to do is come onto the inside of it right here, and off the bottom part of our double piston extender, we're going to put a repeater on 1 tick delay. Next, what we're going to do is make an L shape behind this repeater. So make a nice little L shape like this, and put dust on the back 2 blocks. And then off this block, we're gonna put a repeater, set it to 4 ticks delay. And then on the back of this block right here in the corner, we're gonna put a torch, put a repeater coming out of the torch, set to 3 ticks delay. Then inside of our little tiny hole right here, we're gonna put a sticky piston facing upwards. It will extend up. And then put a block on top of that. That will create a falling edge monostable circuit. Then coming out of our little piston that's facing upwards, we're gonna put a repeater on 1 tick delay. Put a block in front of your repeater, put some dust on top of the block, and then put a block to the left of your dust. Next, what you're going to do is right off the block we just put down, we're going to put a repeater here set to 2 ticks delay. Put a block behind the repeater with dust down on top of it. Then right next to this dust down here, we're going to put a block right above this 1 tick delay repeater with a 1 tick delay repeater going into the block with the dust on it. Next, put a block up behind the 1 tick delay repeater. We can delete that one, it's not needed. Put dust on top of the block. Then put a block to the left of the dust like this. You know what, let's get rid of this tower too because it's going to get in the way. Then come over here and right above our piston that is extended up, put another block right above it. And then put a repeater coming out of this block set to 4 ticks delay. Then we're going to put a block next to this block right here with the dust on it. And put another repeater coming out of this repeater, set it to 3 ticks delay. Then coming off these 2 sticky pistons right here, we're going to put 2 blocks. So 1, 2. And then underneath the block right above this torch, we're going to put a slab upside down. Then delete this block and put a powered rail right here. Now what we're going to do is swing back over here to where this piston right here is that has nothing going to it. And we're going to put our input block right next to it. So just put your input block right next to it. Then down here, we're going to come down a block. And coming out of our input block, we're going to put a repeater on 1 tick delay. And then put dust on top of that, and you're done. That's it. That's one whole side, and you're done. So if we flip it down, it closes. And when we flip it up, it opens up. Now, of course, you're going to be able to see the redstone right here. So what I like to do is just put 1 block of choice right there. And that will hide all the redstone on the inside. But that's it, guys. You are done. So now all we have to do is pretty much just mirror this exact same thing right over here. So all we have to do is just make another little 4x4 spacing. Of course, you don't have to like do what I'm doing right now. I just like to do, I like to make everything look neat. So we got my little 4x4, and then we have to dig out this one extra block right here. So now we just do the same exact thing, guys. So just put your double piston extender right next to the other one. Put your block of choice on top of it. Put your sticky piston next to your block of choice with another block of choice on top of it. Then we're gonna come out three blocks here, 1, 2, and 3. Come over here, put two sticky pistons facing towards you, one facing upwards with a block of choice on top of it, and then delete the two blocks underneath it, and then we start doing redstone again. So coming off the bottom sticky piston right here, we're gonna put a repeater on one tick delay. Then we're gonna make a J shape and put the two redstone dust on the back sides of the blocks, and then put a repeater right here on four ticks delay. Next, we're gonna put a torch off this back corner block with a repeater coming out of it set to 3 ticks delay. Put your sticky piston facing upwards. It should extend up with a block on top of it. That'll create your falling edge monostable circuit. Then coming out of it, we're gonna put a repeater on 1 tick delay. Put a block in front of it with dust on top of it. And then to the right-hand side of it, we're gonna put another block. Then right on top of this block, we're gonna put a repeater on 2 ticks delay. Behind the 2 tick delay repeater, we're gonna put a block with dust on top of it. Then in front of this dust right here, above the repeater, we're gonna put another block with a repeater on top of it on 1 tick delay. Put a block behind the 1 tick delay repeater with dust on top of it. Then to the right-hand side of the dust, we're gonna put a block up next to it. Then we're gonna put a block right above our extended piston with a repeater on 4 ticks delay. Put a block in next to the block with the dust on it with a repeater on 3 ticks delay. Next, we're gonna put two blocks next to these two sticky pistons. Then right above the torch, we're gonna put a slab upside down. Delete this block, put a powered rail, then swing back to the front hand side. Put your input block right here with dust on top of it. And then we're gonna come down a block right here and put a repeater on 1 tick delay. And that's it. So now if I click it, it closes. If I click it again, it opens up, and then all we have to do is put an extra little block right here, and then literally just bring this and wrap it all the way around it like so. So do, just wrap it around it. So it should look something like this. So now if I can put my lever up here now, flip my lever, closes, flip my lever again, it opens up and you're done. See, that's it, you're done. So now if you want it, so when you close it and you're on the inside of it and you don't want to see any of the, you know what, let me just make this real quick like this. So it should look something like this when it's opened up. I like making it 3 down. You can make it 2 down if you want to, but I like making it go 3 because I hate hitting my head on the ceiling. So now if you don't want to see the redstone when you close it like this, if you don't want to see any of this, just delete this wall right here and delete this wall. And then you're going to take out more sticky pistons. And then right here, we're going to put a sticky piston facing towards us. So right here, and then put two more on top of it. Do the same thing over here. Put a sticky piston right here facing towards us. Put two more on top of it. Then take your block of choice and put your blocks of choice right in front of these three sticky pistons. Like that. And then you know what? Let me use a different color here just so you can distinguish the little add-on. We're going to use blue for the add-on. So there we go, blue. So right here in the middle of our three sticky pistons, we're going to put a block with some dust. It should make the top two extend out. And then what we're going to have to do is take out our redstone lamps here and put a redstone lamp underneath it to activate the bottom piston. And do the same thing over here. Put a block right here in the middle with dust, and then a lamp right here. So now if I put my walling right here now, put my walling right here, now you can't see any more of the redstone. So if I click the lever, it opens up. If I click the lever again, it closes and you can't see any of the redstone. All right, guys, so now we're gonna do the little add-on for the button if you still don't know how to do monostable circuits and T flip-flops. So right here where our input blocks are, we're just gonna put another block right here. I'm gonna be using yellow wool for my button block. And then we're gonna put a torch right next to the block, well, right on the block. And then we're gonna put a block right above the torch. This will activate it. Then we're gonna come a block towards this 1 tick delay repeater with a sticky piston facing it towards this block. Next, what we're gonna do is come down a block from our sticky piston, and we're gonna put a repeater going into the block underneath the sticky piston set to 1 tick delay. Next, put a sticky piston facing upwards with a block on top of it, then a block next to the sticky piston with dust on top of it, and then a button right here. Now you can activate it with a button. See? Opens up. Closes. Opens up. Closes. Beautiful. So now what I like to do is literally for the inside button, I'd like to just put it right here to the left-hand side of the creation. Well, actually, we don't have to come out a block. Just put your button right here. and then just literally just wrap it around. Just go like this and wrap it all the way around. Da, 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 da. Very easy. Put a repeater going into this block and then just bring your dust to your button. Like that. So now I can open it up from the inside. Opens up. Closes. And then for the top button, literally, if you want to keep this a secret, then you're going to have to find a spot to hide your button. But if you don't feel like hiding your button, you just want it right up top. What I like to do is just put a block right next to this dust. Put a block right above the dust. Put a repeater going into the block. Set it to one tick delay. Put a block up behind the repeater with dust on top of it. A block of choice on top of the dust. And then a button right here. And now you can open it up from up here. And then, of course, this will be your flooring, so you can't see any of the redstone and whatnot. So this is your whole entire flooring. But there you guys go. That's how you build my two-wide secret staircase. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave it a like and subscribe to stay tuned with my newest videos. All right, guys. Peace.